ice dance is always a popular event and an indicator of pairs to look out for on the major international stage. 16 pairs had already shown what they could do in the short dance routine. On Saturday, it was their chance to allow their artistic side to shine as they went in the free dance. The Russian pair of Victoria Sinitsina and Ruslan Zhiganshin had finished second in Friday's short routine behind the French pair of Pernelle Carron and Lloyd Jones. Taking their inspiration from Bellini's Norma, an opera that promoted Maria Callas to diva status, the Russians set to work. This pair are coached by the veterans Svetlana Alexeyeva and her daughter Elena Kustarova. Alexeyeva knows what it takes to win at the youth level. She won the Soviet junior title back in 1970. Russia have won this title six times since the breakup of the Soviet Union, but there wasn't to be a seventh. Their tally of 85.45 gave them bronze overall. Only good enough for fifth spot in the free dance. Well, a wonderful, dramatic routine that would have made even the great Callas smile, I think. Plenty of applause from the crowd who loved every moment of it. But in the end, only good enough for fifth spot in the free dance, I say, but bronze overall for the two Russians. Their compatriots, Alexandra Stepanova and Ivan Bukin, took third in the category, while Slovakians Federica Testa and Lukas Zolli took second. Neither of those two pairs, though, making the podium in the overall event. Instead, it was the Azerbaijani pair of Julia Zlobina and Alexei Sitnikov who claimed the silver. These two had posted 56.80 points in the short routine, trailing the Russians by just 0.25 points. Of course, Zlobina and Sitnikov represented Russia until 2010 and began competing for Azerbaijan in 2011. They came seventh in the European Championships last season. Add to that that they're coached by Russian ice dance specialist Igor Spilband and Alexander Gorshkov, and you realise this was a medal very definitely forged in Russia. Gorshkov is a legend of ice dancing. He won Olympic gold in 1976 in Innsbruck for the Soviet Union in what was a glittering career. But the soundtrack of Finas, Lobina and Sitnikov posted 85.46, only fourth best on the night, but good enough to sneak them into second overall. Plenty of energy and plenty of emotion in that performance. And certainly in the case of the ice dance, it is a performance. And a great result for the Azerbaijanis, picking up the silver medal. And it was left to the French, though, to sweep the gold medal. Pernelle Carron and Lloyd Jones were outstanding in the short dance programme with a score of 60.35, and with Tchaikovsky's Swan Lake at their back, they were perhaps even better in the free dance. Carron and Jones are coached by the Italian ice dancer Barbara Fusapoli and the Russian Igor Spilband. 27-year-old Carron, an architecture student in Lyon, performed for 12 years with former French champion Edouard Desiter and the World Championship finalist Mathieu Jost, with whom she won the bronze medal in Turin in the 2007 Universiade. She's worked with Jones, who studies at the Lumiere University, also in Lyon, for 4 years. He's an experienced skater. His best performance is 7th in the European Championships, 12th at the world level. An experienced international pair, they were way too good for the rest of the field here in Italy. You can hear the cheers and the whistles and the recognition that really these two were a cut or two above the rest of the field. That's not meant to make it sound bad for the other competitors. These two, though, simply a class above. Their free dance scored them 93.30. They finished 11 points clear of the Azerbaijanis, testament to their dominance in this event. So Carron and Jones take the gold, the first ever for France in the dance. Azerbaijan collect the silver, while the Russians, after picking up gold in Turkey 2 years ago, have to be happy with the bronze.